Welcome back to our channel, especially sa ating mga magaganda at gwapong mga subscribers. Ngayon, if you future namin sa inyo ang Begonia plant, paano ito i-propagate at kung ano ang kanyang mga benefits.
Begonia is a genus of perennial flowering plants in the family Begoniaceae. The genus contains more than 2,000 different plant species. The begonias are native to moist subtropical and tropical climates. Some species are commonly grown indoors as ornamental house plants in cooler climates. Some species are cultivated outside in summertime for their bright, colorful flowers, which have sepals but no petals. Typically used as house plants and in shaded summer beds, begonias have tropical and subtropical origins. Some are grown for their asymmetrical, patterned, and variegated foliage, and others to add color to shady garden areas with their bright blooms. Varieties differ from 6 to 12 inch house plants to bushy plants 5 feet tall or more. Sun to shade exposure depending on variety. Varieties with the most common types, wax and tuberous begonias blooming from early summer until frost. Bloom types may also vary if grown indoors and some types bloom all year. All begonias like evenly moist, well-drained soil with some added organic matter. For general growing purposes, apply a balanced water-soluble fertilizer once a month in the growing season. For plants grow strictly for their foliage, like angel wings, use as a fertilizer that is higher in nitrogen. Some researchers found that these flowers of begonia can also be used as medicines. You can consume begonia flowers by boiling them, then strain and drink the water regularly. These flowers can be beneficial to the health of the body, such as cold medicine, good for the digestive system, brighten the skin, good for bone and teeth growth, treating bronchitis, as a rheumatic remedy, stop the bleeding, natural cough medicine, relieve asthma symptoms, and treating dysentery. However, in addition to consuming health benefits of begonia flower, you also need to consult a doctor. In order for the disease to develop, you can be monitored and avoid the occurrence of complications during treatment using this flower. In addition, maintaining a healthy lifestyle is the best way to keep your body fit. Also for kidney patients, it's not recommended to consume this flower because begonias contain oxalic acid that is harmful to people with the kidney. Thank you.
ating pagtatanim ng begonia plant. Una sa lahat, is kailangan natin i-prepare ang ating planting medium.
40% compost, 40% sandy loam, at 20% rice hulls.
So, meron tayo ditong begonia plant cuttings. So, ito, dwarf begonia na light pink. At ito namang isa is dwarf begonia na light red. At meron din tayong cuttings ng bush begonia. So, meron na tayong tinanim dito sa ating plastic pot. So, dadagdagan na lang natin ito. Yan. Ngayon, itatanim naman natin yung ating mga dwarf begonias dito sa ating mga maliliit na pots. At least, meron tayong mga 4 o 5 cuttings. So, simple lang din. Lalagyan natin natin ng hole sa gitna. Ay ilalagay natin siya. Compress. Tapos, pwede rin natin dagdagan pa ng konti na potting medium or soil. Next, dito naman tayo sa kabila. Ito namang light red color. Same lang din yung procedure. Compact ulit natin. Compress. At dagdagan ng make sure po na yung ating lupa na ginagamit is medyo moist po siya, hindi po siya dry. Itong bush begonia is kailangan po natin siyang itanim sa malaking pot. At ito namang dwarf begonia is pwede natin itanim sa medyo maliit na pots. Ayan na po. Ito na po ang ating begonia plant na tinanim natin sa ating mga pots. Thank you very much. And for more of our videos, don't forget to like and subscribe para maging updated kayo. Thank you once again and God bless.
Thank you.